I'm pleased to announce that this person will be speaking. She's a alumnus of Lincoln High School, where I and Chris teach. And I will let Liz introduce herself, being as a late addition, but here is Liz Shea.
I'm 63 years old, so I've had lots of fish out of the water kinds of things happen. But I think with this audience, all ages, I'm going to talk about a math anxiety. It started in fourth grade when Miss Matika called me up to do a math problem on board, and it scared me to death. It just scared me to death, and I just froze. And have any of you ever known that you know the information, but you just can't do it for some reason? It's just, I don't know what it is. It's like paralyzing. So I remember my dad was a general surgeon, and math was just like no big deal to him. So there were seven kids in my family, and I was the, well, just a middle child. And I would go and ask him for help, and he would just get so rattled trying to help me because he just didn't get why I didn't get it. So I kind of suffered through math, barely making it until when I really realized I had a total math anxiety was in ninth grade when I had to take algebra. And this is true. My math teacher name was Mr. Fink. And he was a really nice guy, but that name, I just thought of that was kind of a quirky name for an algebra teacher, especially if you have a math anxiety. So I kept finding that I would send myself to the nurse's office just before Mr. Fink's class, and I did that as much as I could. And luckily, if I had to do what the kids in this audience need to do now, you guys have to take calculus, don't you? And in high school and all those terrible classes like chemistry and anything math related. I don't care if it's algebra 1, 2, geometry, whatever it is. My last class was 10th grade geometry, and I was a 10th grader. And I positioned myself next to Gary Wooster, so I could look at what his triangles look like and kind of copy them. I can't say the word cheat. I really can't say that. Although I kind of was cheating. But that was my last class, 10th grade geometry. And I was doing just great. I went through school. I got a bachelor's degree at the university. Still no math. And I was safe, until I decided to get a master's degree. It's my third year, and Dr. Cruz, she said, Liz, you're doing great, but you need to take statistics. And I went, excuse me, shit. Oh my God. I mean, I was dying before I even got into class. So I talked to a lot of people, and they said, Liz, take it in the summer. Take it in the summer. It's going to be 5 weeks of hell. But it's better than a semester. So, of course, I signed up for summer school. And my dad, who had mellowed out over the years, he said, Liz, I'm going to get you a tutor. So he found me this great tutor. His name was Craig. He was an actuary student at McAllister. And he was the nicest, skinniest little math tutor in the whole wide world. statistics, the class, and sat in to listen to how my teacher taught, and it was Dr. Anzorki. I love Dr. Anzorki. You know why I love him? I'll tell you in a minute. So Craig realized that the way Dr. Anzorki was teaching, I wasn't going to get it. I mean, Dr. Anzorki just did all the stuff on the board, and then everybody else in the room except me, and I faked it. Yeah, I was doing it. Yeah, I'm doing it. You know, everything's working out on my calculator. I'm doing this. Shit, I wasn't doing anything. I went, all right. So Craig would come over at night, and he would show me how to do it, and then he goes, you aren't getting this, are you, Liz? I go, no. He goes, I'm going to show you a different way. Are you getting it now? No. Okay, let me try something else. I mean, this guy was a genius. I mean, who does that as a teacher can change, and I finally got it. I finally got it. So the first test, I went, and there were 20 questions, and everybody around me was talking about what they got and didn't get, and I felt my math anxiety going like this. And so I went through that test, and then the next day, I went and got my test back, and I looked at it, and I got 3 right out of 23. So I left the class early and I went to where Craig was working, which was at, he was a bartender at Tony Luigi's. I was there at 11 in the morning, I ordered a gin and tonic. He said, you know, and we're chatting, I'm drinking a gin and tonic, 11 in the morning. He's chatting, I'm the only one in the bar. I mean, I'm going, he finally goes, Liz, what are you doing here? I said, Craig, I couldn't even say 3. I said, 5 right. I couldn't even say 3. He said, Liz, you need to go talk to Dr. Anzorki. You need to talk to your teacher. You need this class. And I did. I mean, I had to get that master's degree. It was like my last class. So I went back to university, and this was at Mabel Lee Hall. And you know, if you've been to Mabel Lee, you know it's that lower, you know, you come around the corner and you go up the stairs, but there's a lower level. Dr. Anzorki wore a straw hat. And I was coming around the corner, it was the weekend before the 4th of July, so nobody was on campus. And I saw the straw hat walking. I go, oh my God, that's Dr. Anzorki. And he came up the steps toward me, and I stopped to look at him, and he looked at me, and he goes, Liz. I couldn't believe he knew my name. I know my name. He goes, what happened? I go, Dr. Anzorki, I want to tell you, I knew that stuff. But when I got in that room, everybody just made me so scared. I mean, I was 35 years old, but I felt like a little child. And he said, Liz, I'm going to put you in a room by yourself. He said, I want you to take that class, that test over again after the 4th of July long weekend. I'm going to put you in your room by yourself and see how you do. Well, my first thought was, gosh, I have to study all over again for 4 days. For that test, because I'm one of those overachievers that I will study 23 hours a day and maybe eat a little bit if it comes to doing something really well. So anyway, long story short, I got a C on that test, and that's really all I needed was a blasted C. I just wanted to pass the darn class. So long story short, I signed up for pass-fail, and I got a C. And you know what? I ran into Dr. Anzorki in Russ's Market, and he is my hero. You know, and I know I'm a teacher, I've been a teacher for a long time, but that has made me a better teacher, because I know there's kids in my class that they have some kind of an anxiety, and they want to be really, really good at whatever they do. So I'm just saying, I'm telling you about my math anxiety because I still have it. I mean, there's a graduate student I know walked in here. I had to run and have him teach perspective to my class because I have a math anxiety. And David Clark, I saw you. I saw you come in. I ran down the hall when I was a graduate teaching assistant, and I got David Clark to come in my class and start me out on perspective. And he did it. And then I go, I can do that. I can do that. I'll never forget you, David Clark. And I love you for that. So anyway, that's my 20 minutes. It's supposed to be 10, but I felt like there's something there that I really was, and I still am.